Hi everybody, as I promised, I'm gonna talk about the physiology of cardiovascular and respiratory, hopefully. But remember, just physiology, I'm not talking about pathophysiology of diseases. This chapter is going to be about heart sounds, but there are many things which I will discuss in pathophysiology of cardiovascular. Today is only concepts of what is normal heart sound and some abnormal heart sound for better understanding. Let us start and talk about a little bit anatomy and blood circulation in our cardiovascular system. As you know, we have two atrium and two ventricles. Right atrium, right ventricle, left ventricle, which we divide to the right heart and left heart. As you can see, red for the left heart because it's carrying the fresh blood, highly oxygenated, and right side blue, less oxygenated blood. You must know that how these chambers, four chambers, are connected to each other and to our body system. I draw this simple diagram to make it much easier for you to understand. As you can see, left atrium, left ventricle, right atrium, right ventricle. I start from left atrium, then I will back with one cycle to the left atrium again. You know, left atrium to the left ventricle, we have a valve, we call it mitral valve. Blood is coming to the left ventricle, and after that through the aortic valve, which is here, it will goes to the whole body system from head to toes and give oxygen to all tissues and cells, and finally will be less oxygenated and will back to the right side through the inferior and superior vena cava, as you know, to the right atrium, from right atrium to right ventricle. Remember, between two chambers we have valve, and in exit also we have another valve. Here, right atrium to the right ventricle, we have tricuspid valve, and from over there, pulmonary valve is going to pulmonary artery, going to lungs, and will receive more oxygen, and after that will back to the left atrium to again. This is something you know very well, but just briefly, remember, we have four valves, two in the left side, two right side, which I discuss about how these valves are working and how abnormal sound you can hear when you auscultate the heart sound. After this briefing, let's talk about the normal phase of the heart. Normal phase of the heart, we can divide to two phases, as you know, systole and diastole. Systole, that means contraction of ventricles, which blood will be pumped to the body system from left side, and to the lungs from right side. As you can see, I divided systole and diastole. I would like to tell you what is the normal situation of these four valves in this phase. Systole, simple, pumping blood out of heart. Definitely, valve like aortic valve and pulmonary valve must be open during systole. What about mitral valve and tricuspid valve? Before that, let me remind you, mitral valve and tricuspid valve, we call it atrioventricular valve, or briefly AV valves. Aortic valve and pulmonary valve, we call it semilunar valve, SL in briefing. Let's back. Systole, heart is pumping. Okay, think for a while. Would you like, when heart is pumping, blood goes back to the atrium? No, because the mitral valve and tricuspid valve is between atrium and ventricle. These two valves must be closed during ventricle. During systole, but of course the exit, which is aortic valve and pulmonary valve, must be open. Opposite, during diastole, what is happening? During diastole is relaxation, and blood must come from atrium to ventricles. What do you think? Which valve must be open? Definitely AV valve is inside the heart. Diastole, what is happening is inside the heart, nothing is going out. These two valves must be open, and of course, semilunar valve, which is aorta, and pulmonary valve must be closed because there is no way to be open because it's pointless. Unless it's a pathology. In the normal physiology, it's like that. Let me give you one simple example to make it easy. Imagine one side of the heart as a movie theater. Movie theater, you go to the movie theater, you are waiting for the movie to be started. Each movie theater has two doors, one for entrance, another one for exit. As you can see, the ventricle is like a movie theater. Blood cells are coming here to watch the movie from where? From AV valves. And they go out after movie finished during systole through the semilunar valve, which is of course pulmonary in the right and aortic valve the left side. Very simple and easy. Knowing this helps you to go for next step. Okay. This opening and closing, it makes sounds. Heart has few sounds, which two major ones, which are physiologic, you have to know first. S1. What is the reason of this sound? It's closure of the valves. S1 and S2, both of them. But which valves? S1 is during systole. What is happening? Heart is contracting to push blood to the aorta and pulmonary. Which valve are going to be closed during this time? Mitral? Tricuspid, great. That's why the S1 is closure of these two valves, which produce LAP. S2 is during diastole. That means heart will be relaxed. And the aortic valve and pulmonary valve, which was open during systole, now it's time to be closed. This closure causes second sound, we call it S2, or all together they make a sound like a lap-dap, lap-dap, lap-dap. This is a diagram to show you how we have S1, S2, S1, then S2. As you can see, I play for you, lap-dap, lap-dap. After dap to the next lap, you see the duration is longer. Lap-dap, lap-dap. Why? Because you know in the normal physiology, diastole, the time is longer than systole. Systole is shorter. That's why when you auscult a heart, your patient or normal heart, anybody, how do you differentiate which one is S1 and S2? There are many techniques, and you must know about that, and I will teach you with physical examination later. But very simple, concentrate on duration. Remember, between S2 to S1, time is longer. Locked up, locked up, locked up. Listen to me, after top to the next lap, time is longer, locked up, locked up. Okay, now you understood what is systole, what is diastole, what is happening, what is S1, what is S2, and why we can hear this sound. I draw this picture, S2, A for aortic, P for pulmonary valve, to tell you one fact, which A and P, the pressure in the right and left are not same, and also the amounts of blood in these two chambers are not equal 100%, okay? But the time, because they are very close to each other, you will hear one sound, lap, dop, dop, because A2 and P2 are very close. But sometimes, you know, everybody, in the normal physiology, you will hear two sounds for S2. Instead of hearing lap, dop, you will hear lap, dop, lap, dop, lap, dop. You see, instead of dop, you will hear dub. That means S2 will be split to two sounds. Lub dub, lub dub, lub dub, lub dub, lub dub. What is this? Why is happening? Very simple. We breathe. Inspiration, expiration. Inspiration, expiration. This is happening during inspiration. How and why is very simple. When you breathe, what is happening? The pressure inside the chest wall, chest cavity, will decrease. We have more negative pressure. As a result, blood will be pulled in to the right side of heart. What we have right now, we have more blood during inspiration in right atrium, and as a result, right ventricle. Tell me, when you have more blood in, imagine movie theater. This is a movie theater with same size. You have five people, one in one time, or 500, another time you have 700. Which one takes more time for people to go out? Of course, when you have more, 700. Now you have more blood in right side. What do you think? Right heart is pumping, of heart is pumping right side as well. Then right ventricle needs more time to deliver this blood to pulmonary artery or not? Of course it does. Why? Because it has more blood. As a result, as you can see, P is moving a little bit further. Why? Because it will be closed a bit later. What about aortic wall? Okay. Inspiration, expansion of the lungs. That means alveoli are opening, we are inhaling, giving more gas. And at the same time, physiologically, the blood vessels in the lungs, they keep more blood because those blood need to be oxygenated. It's pointless they deliver more blood. They prefer to keep more blood because we have more gas, then they can exchange. What's next? Okay, lung keep more blood. That means it's not delivering as much as usual to the left side. Left atrium receiving less blood, left ventricle also receiving less blood. Same movie theater. Again, in this side, we have less blood. That means the left ventricle will deliver his blood faster and aortic wall will be closed sooner, as you can see here. Two things is happening. Most important things is pulmonary wall will be closed later because we have more blood in the right side and we have less blood in the left side. This is going to be closed, pulmonary aortic. This is going to be closed later. This is going to be closed sooner. You have gap in between. This gap, we call it splitting of physiological. This is normal, this is not abnormal. Physiological splitting of S2 happening during inspiration. Okay, now you understood about this one, S2 and normal sounds of the heart. Now I can explain what is some abnormal heart sound. All right. After understanding what is S1, S2, and normal splitting, remember, lop-dop, 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 two sound of S2. This is normal. If you auscultate a normal person, you can hear that, but you have to concentrate, and you must know the technique of auscultation. I will teach you when I teach clinical medicine. Now, when you know normal, it's easy to understand abnormal. It's not difficult. Just compare this table with this one. We have two phases, systole and diastole. As a result, we have many type of abnormal sound, but today my concern is only some valvular problem. Later I will teach you the all of those in pathophysiology. Let's concentrate what is happening during systole and diastole. I told you during systole, AV valve must be open or closed? AV valve. Closed, of course. Why? Because it's pointless. The blood delivered from atrium comes back again to the atrium because it's delivering blood to the system. Whatever against that is abnormal. That means normal AV valve must be closed during systole. If it's not fully closed, you can hear abnormal sound. And what about the SL? That means aortic and pulmonary valve. Aortic and pulmonary valve during systole must be open. What is abnormality for that? Not fully open, we call it stenosis. Here, regurgitation over stenosis. Simple. When we have systolic murmur, murmur is abnormal sound because of turbulence of blood flow going from the high pressure to low pressure. Like this. This is murmur. When we have murmur during systole, that means those valves must be closed, are open or not fully closed, or those valves must be open or not fully open. Which one is that? Of course, mitral valve. Now you know, systolic murmur could be mitral regurgitation, tricuspid regurgitation, aortic stenosis, or pulmonary valve stenosis. Simple, very easy. When you know this, you can understand this. Now go for diastolic. What is the normal location, normal situation of this valve during diastole? Diastole is relaxation. There is no blood is going out. That means aortic and pulmonary valve must be closed during diastole. What is abnormal against closed? Not fully closed. Regurgitation, or sometimes we call it insufficiency as well. What about mitral and tricuspid valve? During diastole, these valves must be open to deliver blood to the ventricle for the next systole. Okay, they must be open. What is abnormal against open? Not fully open. We call it stenosis. So, diastolic murmur could be because of mitral stenosis, tricuspid stenosis, aortic valve regurgitation, or we call it AR, or AI as well, and pulmonary, each of them. Yes? Now it's very easy. What is normal, what is abnormal? Now I play some of those, then you can understand. Lap, dop, lap, dop. You remember. Between lap to dop is systole, dop to the next lap is diastole. Lap, dop, lap, dop, lap. Systolic murmur can be like this. Lap, sh, dop. Lap, sh, dop. Lap, sh, dop. Between lap and dop. This is systolic murmur. Diastolic murmur between dop and next lap. Lap, dop, sh, lap, dop, sh, lap, dop, sh. This is diastolic murmur because it's after S2, between S2 and S1, between during diastolic phase is happening. I hope you understood this one very well. Let me, sometimes during exam, normally how they give you the scenario, because for instance in USMLE, in the written exam, they give you case. When they give you case, they have two options. They explain, okay, patient has systolic murmur, of course with some more detail associated symptom to guide you to the diagnose, but right now my point is only systolic or diastolic murmur. Or they give you an audio or diagram like this. You can listen to audio and diagnose, because you must know S1, S2, then is it systolic murmur or diastolic murmur. If you have five options, only one of them, like mitral regurgitation, can give you systolic murmur, the rest of them is something else which is not relevant, you can simply choose. Let's talk about some of them by diagram, and I play for you the sound as well. I don't want to use the recorded audio. You can search in internet and find many of those to test yourself. I am telling you only the main concept. I chose aortic and mitral because they are more common, but pulmonary is as simple as aortic and tricuspid same as mitral valve. Aortic valve, how many abnormality? Pathologically many, but for this part we have AS, aortic stenosis, and AI. I ask you, aortic stenosis, is systolic murmur, has systolic murmur or diastolic murmur? Stenosis, the time aortic valve must be open, is not fully open. When aortic valve systolic, oh, it's systolic murmur. Okay, that means, you see, between S1 and S2, systolic murmur. Aortic regurgitation, that means against closure. When aortic valve must be closed, aortic valve must be closed during diastole. Okay, now it's not fully closed, that's why it's diastolic murmur. You see this red? It's during diastolic phase. Mitral stenosis, against opening. Mitral valve must be open during diastole, not fully open. So that's a diastolic murmur. And mitral regurgitation. Okay, regurgitation again closure. When mitral valve must be closed, definitely it must be closed during systole. When it's not fully closed, we have regurgitation. But why, you see, we call it crescendo, decrescendo, or here decrescendo. I explained very fast about this to make it easy for you to understand. Then I start from here. Mitral regurgitation. That means here the heart is going to pump blood to the aortic valve. Mitral valve must be closed, but it's not fully closed. That means the amount of your blood is going here during systole, which causes turbulence and extra sound like a murmur, like this. This is systolic murmur of mitral regurgitation, and is, as you can see, sustained, is not changing. As much as blood is pumping, portion of blood is going to the aorta, portion is going to a left atrium. It causes sustainable, very fixed sound. What about aortic stenosis? Aortic stenosis, the problem is during systole. As you know, during systole, first we have a lot of blood, and our left ventricle forcefully pushing this blood to the aortic wall. That means the force is very high, and eventually it will, because it definitely deliver blood to aorta, but when the amounts of blood and pressure is decreased, then you can hear the sound of the murmur will decrease, eventually going high, because you have more blood and more pressure, make more sounds, and at the half, it will back to the low. That means like this, it's a systolic murmur. It's a systolic murmur. I play like a la, shh, top, la, shh, top, la, shh. First it's going high, then going down, then still. That's the way you can differentiate. And one more, aortic regurgitation. Okay, regurgitation, that means the aortic valve must be closed, but it's not fully closed. When is that? During diastole. Aortic valve must be closed, it's not fully closed. Blood is going back to the ventricle. But you know, this blood, because it's delivered to the aorta, isn't delivering to the body system as well. That means initially we have more amounts of blood, it makes more sound when it regurgitates. Eventually at the end of diastole you don't have that much blood, the blood is less, and it makes less turbulence and less sound. That's why it's decrescendo, the sound of murmur will decrease. It's like that, laptop, laptop, laptop. That means the sound is gradually decreasing. Explanation is very simple, because the amount of blood is decreasing. The rest of blood is going to the system for oxygenation. I think this is enough for this lecture, but it's not enough for abnormal heart sound. I haven't done ASD, VSD, PD, and others, which I hope I will continue in pathophysiology this part. Thank you so much.